guys, Dave from Wells Roots, and today's short little video is inspired by the comments that I saw on a Canadian Tire website in regards to food grade buckets or pails. So I was looking through the comments because I was deciding on whether or not I was going to buy some from that particular place, and I started seeing comments about, you know, don't buy these, they're no good, the lids don't fit properly, they don't seal properly, so on and so forth. And I saw a few of them and I thought, well, you know, I'll take the chance because they're fairly inexpensive. So I bought them, I bought the lids, I bought the buckets, the pails, and they fit great. I had no complaint about it whatsoever. So then I was thinking about it and I thought, maybe these guys didn't know how to put them on. I mean, because you can get the lids onto the pails, you know, where they seem to be seated properly, but they're not. And so I thought, maybe some people out there just really don't know how to put the lids on a pail. So, you know, I mean, it can happen, right? So long and short of it, I just thought maybe I'd make a food grade bucket pail review. And not a review, but how to, I guess, what to look for, so on and so forth. Because to be honest with you, when I first started looking at food grade buckets, I didn't know what to look for either. So first things first, a food grade bucket, and you probably won't be able to see this, so I will. Food grade bucket should have a triangle. Let's see if I can get that in there. On the bottom of the bucket. All right, it's a recycling triangle. And it will have a number one or a number two on it. It's got a number one and a number two, or a number two and a recycling type triangle. Then you got yourself a food grade bucket. And the difference between a food grade bucket and a regular bucket is that the food grade bucket won't allow as much oxygen transfer. Okay, so you won't get as much oxygen into the bucket as you would with a regular bucket. And that's the difference. So this is a food grade bucket. This happens to be just from Canadian Tire. Lots of other companies sell food grade buckets. So that's number one done. Number two are just the standard lids. This is just a standard lid. Comes with the, doesn't come with it, you gotta buy it extra, with the food grade bucket, all right? These lids I ordered off of Amazon. I think they were around 10 bucks a piece. I'll put a link for the Canadian site anyway, because I'm Canadian. These are gamma lids. These are awesome, okay? Gamma lids, the outside, take that off, the outside seal, or lip, I should say, seals on 100 times better than a standard lid does. And, I mean, to try and get one of these off once it's on, like, you probably end up breaking it. So I'll show you how to put this on, and I'll show you how to put the other lid on as well. But once you're seated, like once you get that lid on properly, or the rim, I'm gonna call it this, it should be extremely difficult to take back off again, okay? So what's awesome about the gamma is that you put this onto the pail first, and then you have your lid, and your lid just screws on. So your lid just screws on and it seals down tight. And the lid itself has its own seal on it. So this rim, you can see here, this rim has a black seal inside. It's a thick black seal. And then your lid has a white seal around the edge here. It's really difficult to see white on white, but there is a rubberized seal on here as well. So you tighten that down, and then you're good to go. So, and that's for a bucket that you're gonna probably go into all the time. You want easy access to. Okay, so here's your bucket. This is a lid. Now the lid can be pushed on somewhat. Try really hard. Once you got this on, you can use a mallet to make sure that it's sealed on tight. And that's what I would suggest doing. Because while I'm using my mallet, it's going to be impossible to show you, so you're just going to have to take my word for it. Sorry, it's really hot out. I'm sweating like crazy. It's impossible to show you. But once you use your mallet, you can actually see it's sealing down better than if you were just you just pushed it down. And once that's on, it is on tight. Like, seriously, take this off. I'll take it off for you just to demonstrate. But they're actually really difficult to get off, so. Once you got it going, then it's not as bad, but it's the initial start. So that's a regular lid. Gamma lid, I'm not gonna take off for you because, like I said, I'll probably end up breaking it. So the gamma lid goes on the same way, except you're missing your top portion. This is just a rim, okay? So to put your rim on, you wanna start it off. I don't even know if I can start it off. The first time I put one of these on, I thought that it didn't fit. And I was wrong. It did fit. They're just extremely difficult to get on. So again, this is where your rubber mallet comes into play. Now she's on. I think it's on. Yep. Looks good. Yep. Then your lid just spins shut. Just like that. That's it. Just peel off. That's essentially it. The only other thing I would add to this video is use a rubber mallet. Don't use a steel hammer, otherwise you're gonna end up cracking either your standardized lid or you'll crack this this rim that goes on. So, it's really hot in here. Use a rubber mallet. They're inexpensive to buy. If you're buying buckets and lids, you can probably afford to buy a mallet. They're only like $5 to $10 Canadian. If you absolutely cannot find one or get one or afford to get one, you can use a regular hammer, like a steel hammer. Just put wood on it. So put like a 2x4 on it and then hit the 2x4 instead of hitting directly onto the rim. Otherwise, like I said, you're gonna crack it. Once it's cracked, it's useless, it's garbage. So out of that, or you can make yourself a wood mallet. If you have wood laying around, make yourself a wood mallet. I'm not going to get into that on this video, but make yourself a wood mallet. That would work as well. All right. But the rubber mallets are pretty inexpensive, like I said. So that's it. So if you can afford the gammas, grab yourself a gamma. I didn't buy gammas for all my blue gray buckets. I bought regular lids for every bucket. And then I bought like half a dozen gammas, just for the ones that we're gonna be going in and out of all the time. So I figured that would be good enough for me anyway. So it can get expensive once you start, you know, doing these sort of things. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video and hope you guys got something out of it. Leave your comments and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch you on the next one.